I did not know that you could be get a strike for even criticizing a plant form. Did not know that. Did you?
I didn't.
Hey, fellow YouTuber. By the name of Matt Orfile was got a strike for criticizing YouTube's censorship. For criticizing. Just for even criticizing YouTube. That's makes no sense, really. That's like you getting your Facebook page suspended because you criticized Facebook, or your Twitter page for criticizing Twitter, and they're even getting suspended for even criticizing Twitter and their censorship. Now, Matt Orfiles, he was talking about, here, I'm going to put it here.
Typical videos received his latest strike for an old fake Starbucks ad. After contacting YouTube, the platform agreed that he was not promoting organized crime.
Well, it says he tweeted, after falsely accusing him of involving with most violent criminal organizations, demonetizing his entire channel and threatening to delete it with another strike, Team YouTube says they made an error. But his hundreds of previously monetized videos are still no longer monetized.
And lifted the strike. It's just the latest in a series of run-ins Orfiles had with the platform. He's also been penalized for contact on the drug Limvaxine, which is...
Now, I can understand, you know, if you fucked up by really, really fucking up and to be held accountable. That I do agree. Anybody can get punked, have a strike or a video taken down or whatever that may be if you fucked up. I mean, really fucked up just to fuck up, you know. But there are, like, I mean, if you had a video taken down and been demonetized and whatnot, for whatever reason that may be, but the thing is, you want to know why your video was removed, you know, or why you got the strike, or why your videos are no longer monetized, you know. Same for me, I don't make money. It's never about the money. Never has been. If it was, I could be making money doing this, you know. It's just that. I mean, it probably depends on how many videos you got, how many viewers, or what. I mean, I don't know. But having your videos demonetized, I mean, he got censored, you know, and is also talking about certain medications that may work on COVID, but their algorithms, you know, is searching for that particular, you know, word, you know, particular word, you know. And it's like Facebook's algorithm or Twitter's algorithm doing the same thing. Okay. Now, every platform, whether it's big tech or alt tech, you know, how they're saying it, isn't it? There is a term of service as well as guidelines, things you cannot do, things you can do, which some have violated it on purpose or without even really knowing it, you know. I mean, that's a very understandable, you know. But I would also question, hey, check this out, you know, hey, just out here, you know, but my question is this, okay? My question is this. Now, I was going to talk about the January 6th event, incident that happened. Not an event, it's an incident. And I was also going to talk about it too. But, might as well. I don't know if it is. Honestly, I do not know if this video would get removed. And whatever reason that may be, I don't know. But YouTube has becoming childish within the last, I would say, since July of 2016, when they purged over 50 channels, all within a 2 to 3 week span. You know, there was a couple of channels that I am subscribed to, and one of them was the Doctor of Common Sense, you know. Red Pill Revolution. Now, I've been subscribed to that channel for a while before it got completely just boom. You know. And these are channels that are challenging the status quo, questioning the status quo. I want to talk about the January 6th incident. Can't call it an event because nothing good came out of that. No. But a young lady was shot and killed that very same day. There were some, I mean, there was a lot of people. How many? I can't say, because there was a lot of people. I mean, damn, a lot of people. There's a mixture of Trump supporters and other unknown groups, you know. But from what I watched an hour and a half documentary on this shit. I'm like, man. Even the police are having a hard time keeping everybody, you know, back, you know. But the thing is, whatever happened, man, I will agree, it is really royally fucked up. No, I didn't agree with, I mean, the heart and mind is in the right place, but their actions were something I wouldn't do. That's like of the event of rushing Area 51. No. But it's more of an event of song and dance, just kind of like a big UFO powwow. People at Area 51, they were out there, they were just, but it was a celebration of, look, I believe in aliens like everybody else, who is an alien, like, who wants to know if there's aliens out there, and do they, I'm like, look, I don't question. But do I believe? To a degree. But I've always been into aliens and shit. But there's things I wouldn't do. I mean, there are things you wouldn't catch me doing. The Russian Air 51. I wouldn't do that. Or rushing the Capitol. That's one thing I would not do. Why? Because I don't feel like sitting in a federal prison cell. I don't feel like going to prison for life for something that the heart and mind is in the right place, but their actions what got them in this mess in the first place. Do I condone it? No. I it's one thing I would not do. But there is a lot of questions. There is a lot of questions that's being asked. A lot of theories, a lot of questions, a lot of wonders. There's going to be some buildings that are going to be occupied in here in California. Also in Florida. While those two states, they arrested six people in Florida who were supposedly or allegedly involved in the January 6th incident. I would question that too. That I would question. Now, there was a young lady who was shot. They don't know if she was shot in the neck, shot in the chest, shot in the arm, or what, but she died. And, I can understand, you want to stand up for your country and have no trust in the Democrats or Republicans. That's understandable, But when you have big tech, censoring this guy, Matt Orfele, he talked about the same thing on another channel. And even that channel got censored and shit, But they're creating this predictive algorithm on to look for certain key things. Why? Easy. Censorship. I admitted long time ago, I am a conservative, but I'm also a libertarian. And I do believe in the Constitution, the supreme law of the land. We kicked old King George III. And after we kicked his ass, he went fucking nuts. We sent his red-coated bastard back home. And it became a nation. That's when the expansion happened. We went from 13 states, 13 colonies, to this big juggernaut, what we are today, you know. And I think that, you know, it was probably the right thing to expand, you know, because, let me see here, what the hell, what the fuck, got a message, got a text and shit. Okay. Okay, let's see here. Chances went up to $100 for waiting, as waiting for you here. From T-Mobile. mobile.us.nyc.1.upcloudobjects.com/T-Mobile/1659337.hotmail. That's kind of funny, but I'm not going to click on it, so I'll just leave it alone. Now, I mean, like I said, I mean, there's things that I mean, that happened on that day. I feel like I don't feel like, I mean, it's something that you wouldn't catch me doing because I don't feel like getting shot. I don't feel like getting, you know, getting trouble and shit. I would rather sit home. So where am I at? I'm home. I mean, all that crap. I don't know how many people died. I don't know how many officers died. I don't know if any member of Congress or in the Senate got hurt. I mean, nobody knows. I mean, but I will call some of them out because, look, I can understand you're angry. I can understand you're frustrated over the vote of the election, okay? I can understand that. I felt the same way, too. But we all got to understand what's done is done. I mean, if you really want to do something, make it positive, not this violent shit, because if we do this violent shit, we are no worse, no better than fucking Antifa and BLM, man. You gotta use your fucking head, man. You know what I mean? Come on, dude. You gotta use your fucking head, man. Because if you go violence with violence, look. Capitol Police. They did, I mean, some of you dumbasses overrode these guys. They're doing their job, man. They're doing their job. They're getting paid to protect the Capitol, man. I mean, I can understand your anger, but what you did, okay? You guys fucked up. You guys fucked up. You claim to be patriots, right? You claim to be patriots? I'm one too. But you don't see me, you know, rushing the Capitol. You don't see me doing stupid shit. Use your fucking brain, dude. Use your fucking head, man. Again, I can understand you're angry, you're frustrated, okay? Look. The court are doing their job, okay? You have to be smarter than this. But some of you that got arrested for it, I hope you got what you deserve. It's your fault. You know, all you did I agree. Because, I mean, with what they did, they became no better than Antifa and BLM. Okay. I can understand the anger, the frustration, you know, all that, you know. But it's one thing I wouldn't do, because look, I am pro-cop, but I'm also anti-police brutality. Okay. I am anti-thin blue line. I hate the thin blue line. I hate the big blue, the big wall of silence and shit. I believe in protecting, you know, yeah. But there's a lot of questioning on, is it an inside job? Because for example here, there's a footage of a member of Congress opening the back door. Open the back door. And letting these people in. I just think that, you know, people need to think, man, you know, people need to understand, you know, that we understand they're angry. Understandable. No bullshit. No more, no less. Okay? I've always been for smaller government. Big government's too damn big. Too big, too corrupt. It's like, I mean, what I want to see, the banks and big tech broken up, okay, big time. But here you got Matt Orfale. He got accused of being involved in a violent criminal organization. And demonetized his channel, threatened to delete his channel with another strike. But YouTube says it's an error. We made it another error. Made an error. Really? An error? An error? I mean, dude. When did YouTube admit we made an error? They didn't make no fucking error, man. You know, like, dude. Only error they ever made was hiring that dumb broad, Susan Wojcicki, or Susan Smelly Crotchy, or Susan Fire Crotch, or Susan Ice Crotch, or whatever. Like, what the hell? But, I mean, we all know what she said. You know, what she said. If anybody talk, yeah. mean, you know, like I said, I mean, their heart and mind is in the right place, but if you're willing to risk dying, I mean, if you're willing to risk getting yourself killed, because they have highly trained people, period. After they brought in the National Guard, I mean, they brought in a lot. Okay. Now, my question is this. I mean, you see, you hear about Antifa just in like Trump supporters doing this shit. And then you have Trump supporters saying, no, it was supposed to be peaceful, and shit. But I'm not still waiting on it, man, But now here's something I also want to throw in there too. Nancy Pelosi and the DOJ is planning to release a invisible army. Okay. Now, I'm thinking we have the Navy, the Army, Navy, Air Force, and Marines, and the Coast Guard. And also Space Force. Why do we need an invisible army? But come find out, it is a blimp. It's a blimp. Okay. And what it is, it's a Lockheed Martin 74K Aerostat. Go ahead and Google or Bing it. Search it. It's a Lockheed Martin 74K Aerostat. AEROSTAT. That's the blimp. That's the blimp. Lockheed Martin 74K Aerostat. So guys, go ahead and Google or Bing it. Get more info on it if you want. Now let me see here. Let me I'll do it myself too. Okay. It's a persistent surveillance system. Okay, Yeah, they're going to use a Lockheed Martin 74K Aerostat. But they approved a sale of one in the amount of $525 million to Saudi Arabia. Okay. That's the blimp right there. That's the one right there. That's Lockheed Martin 74K Aerostat. U.S. Army awarded a Lockheed Martin $133 million to provide persistent threat detection. They have a radar system. A tethered aerostat radar system, TARS. It's American low-level airborne ground. MORAD balloons as radar platform, similar system included the ELM-2083 and the JLENSs. They have a Lockheed Martin 420K2, Lockheed Martin 275K. So they're going to be using this, and it'll be used all over the country. They're going to be using it in California and Florida, as well as the capital area. Shit. Manufacturer Lockheed Martin, prime contractor ILC Dover Envelope. They have 9 Lockheed Martin 420K. They have 2 Lockheed Martin 275K. They're going to be using those because of the January 6th and stuff. So I mean, what happened that day was like really fucked up. Fucking Bunker Hill, man. You know, just going up there, just. But they did stop the vote partially. They partially stopped the vote. But again, I did not. I feel like you guys should have thought, man. You should use your head, bro. All right. But. They're trying to find a way to keep President Trump from running for any office, which they cannot do that. You know, anybody has the right to vote to run for office. No. I mean, if you're a farmer or a doctor or whoever, if you want to run for office, go for it. Knock yourself out. No. Be my guest. But I would thoroughly, really think about it, you know. I mean, I just feel that people need to start using their fucking head, man. But what happened that day made them look even as worse as Antifa and the BLM network. Total bullshit. total bullshit. But again, what happened, happened. You know, it's their fuck up, not mine. I just think that, you know, here they're willing to get themselves killed, they're willing to get themselves arrested, and maybe even set up. And stuff, so, I mean, I don't know. I think that they should have used their head, should have, you know, started thinking and shit, you know, like, what the fuck, you know? I just feel like there has to be this understanding, you know. I just feel like, you know, there's a point to if people would start using their fucking head. But it's over, it's dealt with, but now we're hearing about Speaker Pelosi and the DOJ releasing this fat fucking blimp and shit, surveilling people, you know. Look, not everybody agreed to that shit. What happened on January 6th? I didn't agree with it. Even though their heart and mind was in the right place, but physically, they fucked up. They fucked up big time. But it's something that I would not do. I don't feel like getting myself arrested or shot, you know, whatever it is, you know. But there is questions. There is reports, new reports that's coming out now. The FBI totally fucked up. The FBI totally dropped the fucking ball. Really dropped the fucking ball. And I think there has to be a big investigation, also a big investigation on the FBI and the CIA. Of course, you know, about Speaker Pelosi, her husband bought some stock in big tech. So did she. $4.5 million worth. Of course, she denied it, but she did. And this is probably why they want to stop that antitrust case, you know, which could be some kind of bullshit that they're trying to do. Well, it looks like Mr. Pelosi bought some stock in big tech. How much? Don't know. But it looks like that Speaker Pelosi bought about $4.5 million in shares in Google and a couple other companies and shit. And, I mean, like, dude, they're doing this to stop, you know, the loss of the shit, too. I kind of find it's kind of chicken shit. Also, kind of bullshit. You know? There's people that have but I do kind of find it as bullshit. I do. All right, folks, this is good old Grimlock. Agent Grimlock, my agent of farts. FAF.A.RT.TS.farts. And if you're new to this channel, please leave a like, subscribe, comment below, please share this video. Always be healthy, well, and wise. I love you guys. And if you're new to this, and if you've got this transmission, you are the resistance. And I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace out. Godspeed.